So, I'm apparently supposed to talk about this Hopper thing. Hi, and welcome to my reflection video. So, for the past month, I was completely lost on how to go about this project. My heart, after reading, the 18-page article, and after looking online for some animal to give me some inspiration on how to do my Hopper, I set my soul and heart on a tree frog. Because a tree frog, well, a frog in general is the first thing that comes to mind, I think, when you think of a hopper in nature. My goal was to not only make a frog that jumped, right, a hopper, but to also make it really aesthetically pleasing, because that was something that is really important to me as an artist, and I wanted to make sure that everyone who saw my hopper and saw it move really picked off that it was a frog. Now, for the first couple of weeks, it was really hard to even go about this because I wasn't sure whether to use spring wire, whether to use rubber tubing. There were so many things that I could have done in order to replicate the movement of a frog. And with the amount of joints it had, it just made it 10 times worse. I ended up having this first design. And this design was horrible. I mean, it didn't even do anything. I tried to, replicate the legs on how to move, but it was just nothing. There was just nothing I could think of that would make it hop or do anything like that. But then I had a vision. So one night I fell asleep and I was dreaming so intensely, and for some reason I woke up with an idea on how to make a frog hopper, and I was like, you know what? This is it. So quickly got out of bed that next morning. I woke up, started drawing it, and this is my first sketch that I had when I drew it out. This is my first sketch. I just grabbed a pen and started doodling away, and the thing is, that's my experimental prototype. So now my hopper actually kind of looks like a frog now. So as soon as I could, I went to the lab, started drawing on the Yuka board, started cutting out parts, and I made my hopper. And it looks like this. It's my hopper. So my hopper has a rectangular base right now with some wooden dowels acting as joints for it. Now, the really cool thing about this is that I'm only focused on the second pair of joints. That's where all the tension is stored in for my hopper. The legs are rubber banded right now, but eventually I will have a close fit at the end of the leg, and that will help make the design more stable and more secure. The rubber tubing on the bottom helps with the friction grip, and I hope it will help it launch and be able to impulse off the table more. However, I am missing some front legs that help it go on an incline because that is part of my design goal. So, what is my design goal? Well, I want my frog to look aesthetic as hell. And I also wanted to not only have a vertical displacement, but I also wanted to have a horizontal displacement, because if you see frogs in nature, just like this one, you see them jump from tree to tree or from branch to branch. And they don't just jump vertically, they also jump horizontally. So that was something that I really wanted to emphasize in this project. So again, this is my experimental prototype. His name is Froggy. And Froggy right now is under construction because, like I said, I was super hyped on building this and I didn't really have time to CAD it or whatnot. I just wanted to see if the concept worked. So enough talk about this hopper thing that I dreamed about. Let's see if it actually hops. All right, so we're about to test my hopper. It's time to do the switcheroo. It's okay. Personally, my current experimental prototype meets 50% of my design goal. So my frog hopper jumps vertically, and that's pretty good because that's part of my design goal, but it doesn't really do the horizontal displacement too well. However, it does really resemble a frog because, as you can see, these parts kind of look like a frog when it jumps. However, with some more CADing and actually laser cutting my parts, I'm gonna be able to have it look like a real frog and hopefully make some legs that aren't ballooned and have front legs that help it stand at an incline, because that's how I want it to launch. Of course, there are some design changes that I need to do with this hopper. There are three specific ones that I think are important. in order for me to advance to my next stage, which is adding a trigger. My first change has to do with the grip on the feet. Personally, I added some grip on the feet, but it's not at a point where if I added an incline, the rubber tubing does anything. It's kind of hard, and I have to experiment, I have to redesign how I'm going to add the rubber tubing to act as a friction hold and how it can be most effective. I want to be able to redesign the feet so that they actually look like the tree frog's feet with the webbed kind of structure, or maybe that helps it hop a certain way. So as you saw, my hopper doesn't really jump horizontally, and that's something I need to change because it's a part of my design goal. Adding it on an incline will allow me to not only have it go up, but also horizontally, and I think that's something to look forward to. So now my third change in my design, it has to do with the fact that I kind of freehanded this torso. And the torso, as you can see, my torso isn't really looking like a hopper. And in fact, the wooden dowels on it are freehanded. So that kind of adds to the reason why my hopper kind of spins. So that's something I need to change as well. Last but not least, I have to be able to mount a trigger and a capacitor on this body, because that is going to be how I'm going to be able to let it go and for it to do it by itself, essentially. So ultimately, I thank my vision from that night, because my hopper now looks like a frog and it doesn't look like whatever I had in the beginning. So I'm excited to go and see what else I can do to improve this hopper.